Over the next few minutes, we're going to discuss mass data features. And what we're going to be doing is migrating data in and out of the system, importing and exporting, okay? First one we're going to look at is the ASCII transfer. And where we're going to start is actually in Microsoft Office in Excel. So I have just a template already created that we've already drawn into the system. And we're going to pretend like we're updating stock levels and things like that. But this actually can be used as your initial import, and we'll show you where those buttons are going to be located, okay? So right here we have our description, our barcode, our cost, the in-stock, the price, the department, and the retail price, okay? So this is where it's all going to be. Now these are going to be case sensitive, so be careful with that. So let's actually bring an item into the spreadsheet now. Great, so we have the 12-ounce Sprite can right there. Let's draw the barcode into the cell right here, into this column. And what I'd like you to see is that if we were to actually continue scanning barcodes, that if you just wanted to go and add multiple items at a time, you can go and you can draw multiple items, and you can see that it's just going to populate in a downward or descending fashion within this column, okay? So I wanted you to see that if you have multiple items in front of you and you want to update the list or make changes, that it's easy to do, okay? The other thing I'd like to show you is the remainder of creating this item. So we're going to put a cost in there. And then we're going to put the in stock, we'll say 15. And then we're going to have the price. And then we'll have the department, remember, case sensitive. And then the retail price, okay? And that's going to complete the Microsoft Excel portion. Now we're going to save this as a CSV file to our desktop. And you can see right here that we've saved it as a CSV. Now we're going to rename the file to .txt. Press enter. Yes, I would like to make the change. And you can see that it's made the change. Now let's look at this really quick and see what we need to delete, because we actually did use the comma delimited. And you can see that the actual description, barcode, cost, all those things are in there. So let's take that out. And then we'll save our changes. We'll close this. Now let's open up Cash Register Express and see the ASCII Transfer feature at work. We're going to go to Options, Tools, ASCII Transfer. This window is going to come up to ask us for our password, and then the other ASCII Transfer window is going to come up. Now, we have the import inventory right here. You can also export invoices. The data format we're going to choose is general. The delimiter used, make sure you choose comma delimited. And we can do replace in stock, add in stock, and let's just go ahead and make the import. Let's choose the tax. We'll choose the TXT file that's on our desktop. We'll open it. The import is complete. 0 new items were added. 8 existing items were updated. And that's the ASCII transfer feature. Let's look at something that we had in the spreadsheet and look at its stock level now and its attributes. All right, the same Sprite can. You can see right here that we actually made all those specific attribute changes, and we have 35 in stock, and you can see that the ASCII transfer feature worked like a charm. It's a great feature. Let's move on to talk about global price changes. For global price changes, we're going to go to Administrative, Global Price Changes, and this window is going to appear right here, okay? Now, with Global Price Changes, we have a few different choices that we can have. So just for, I guess, for demonstration purposes, we're going to make changes globally to items within a department. But you can make changes to all items, and all of these are your choices over here, a price change, a set sale price, assign tax, apply a percent discount, and then a percent price increase. So if you want to use any of those, definitely it's there. Now, reminder, there is no undo function, so you just need to be very careful about what you're doing. So let's choose items in a department, and this is where you're going to select your department. Now, they do have numerical values here, and so if you don't quite remember your numerical value, go ahead and click on it, and you can see that all of it's going to be right here, and you say, okay, great, that is the department that I want. And so then now we have the correct department. Let's go ahead and set a sale price, and this will apply for all of the selected items for the store. Are you sure you'd like to do this? Yes, for this department. And this new sale price is going to be a flat price right here. So we're going to make it $30. and please enter the start date. It's going to have one individually populated for today, and you can make that change. And then this one has a default as well, and you can change that to your liking. So we're going to press OK. Your sale prices have been applied. And you can see that it's very easy to use the global inventory, the global price changes. And it's a great tool. But remember, no undo button, so just be careful what you're doing. And that's going to cover all of our mass data changes.